much to update you guys on, like, what has happened last night, what is happening today, what has been going on, girl. So I already did my eyebrows just because, yeah. I'm gonna tell you guys what I was using though. My Numbosum toner. I used that before. Like, I wish I had that clip. Little glow recipe. Dewdrops. That's what, like, I have is, like, primed on my skin. And then we're gonna do some more things. I'm currently in California right now. This is, like, a very, very last minute trip, but also, like, not last minute. I mean, like, kind of last minute. Like, this was, like, over the last of, like, this was planned probably like a week and a half ago. Which is, like, usually I'm not a spur of the moment type of girly, but we were today. I'm using both the Makeup by Mario Ethereal Eyes palette today, and I think I'm also gonna mix it with the neutrals. I think I'm gonna mainly do this, but then, like, I like the glitter shade, so I don't know. I don't know what kind of vibe we're gonna go for. We literally were supposed to do, here's the thing, it's like 12:45, and the whole plan was that we were supposed to wake up really early. I'm talking like 8 a.m. or something like that, or like 7 a.m. Be ready so we can go to, like, breakfast on the beach. Sorry if you can hear somebody's upstairs moving. I don't freaking know. Honestly, it's driving me insane and I kind of want to scream, but, like, we're trying just not to think about it, okay? We're trying not to think about it. But basically, yeah. So we were supposed to wake up, all that stuff, go to the beach and have breakfast on the beach, and, like, that's, like, what our plan was. But then, guys, we were under the impression that, like, last night we were gonna go to bed early, and then we didn't go home until, like, 3 a.m. So let's talk about that. Today I got here 2 days ago on, like, the night, but let's talk about the day that I was leaving. Guys, so basically, what day was I leaving? I was coming here on a Friday. Yeah, Friday night I was supposed to get here, right? Friday night. And here's the thing. I bought this really freaking beautiful, gorgeous, like, I don't know what it was. I think it was like House of TV. I don't freaking know what kind of dress it was. And basically it was supposed to come in time. Like, I ordered it enough to wear, like, it would have arrived before I left. But it didn't, and they waited so long to ship it. So I'm like, here I am, like, 3 days. Like, what are those people doing? Sorry, like, if you can hear that. I'm sitting here panicking. I'm like, oh my God, I don't have anything to wear. Like, obviously I have a lot of clothes, but, like, we want something new. We want something we haven't worn before. You know, it's one outfit, you know, you get it. I feel like the girlies get it, the girlies. Basically, I thought to myself, I'm like, okay, what's gonna come in time? What's gonna come in time? Because I can go to the mall, and the mall's just not gonna have cute things. It's really not gonna have as cute things as it does online. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just not. I'm thinking, okay, Fashion Nova ships usually within, like, 2 to 3 days or whatever. I was like, they ship from California. I live it. Like, that's gonna drive me nuts. But I know ships very, very quickly. So I placed myself literally a, like, over $200-something Fashion Nova order. It's supposed to arrive the day before I leave. So it's supposed to arrive on Thursday. I'm supposed to leave on a Friday. Well, it never comes on Thursday, girl. It never shows up on Thursday, it doesn't. So finally I get the notification saying, girl, it's gonna show up on Friday by 2 p.m. I gotta be to the airport by, like, literally, like, 6, okay, 6. My flight leaves at 8. Like, I need to be there at least by 6 because it was, like, a weekend. It's a Friday. It's Phoenix Sky Harbor Airport. Like, if you guys know anything, it's one of our main, it's one of, like, a big main airport a lot of people are traveling through, though. So I was like, girl, like, how am I gonna get through this? Like, how am I gonna get through this? All this type of stuff, right? So basically, I'm sitting here panicking because I'm like, okay, my package was supposed to arrive at 2. Didn't come at 2. Didn't come at 3. If it didn't come at 4, and it didn't come at 5. And so now I'm at the point where, like, I need to be in an Uber because, like, because of traffic hour and, like, where I live, like, the airport's going to be 45 minutes from, like, where I am, right? It typically can be a 20-minute drive, but, like, with the traffic and all that stuff, like, we're looking at, like, a fine, like, you know, like, 45-minute drive to the airport. So I'm like, oh my God, I'm not going to get there in time. Like, I can't leave without my package. So I was thinking to myself, I was like, okay, worst comes to worst, I'll cancel my flight, I'll fly the next day. But I didn't want to do that because it was gonna be like $100. Like, I already spent like $300 on flight plus $100 extra. Like, no, I don't want to do that. So my package literally arrives. My package literally arrives at 6:30. I get in an Uber somehow by 6:40. I rip my package open, throw it in my suitcase, somehow get an Uber by 6:40, and then I make it to the airport by 7:10. The lady dropped me off in baggage claim. She dropped me off in baggage claim. Baggage claim is where you get picked up. So I'm like, I've never been dropped off in baggage claim. Like, where the fuck do I go? I'm sprinting, running through the airport to get, because my flight boards at 7:40. It is 7:10. I haven't checked my bags, haven't got my fucking ticket. I haven't gone through security. Babe. I just wanted to preface, I am a very anxiety type of person. So doing all of this last minute, I like to show up to the airport 2 hours early. There's two types of people in this world. There's people that show up 3 minutes before their flight, and there's people that show up 2 hours. I'm a 2 hour girly because I have anxiety, and, like, the day of a flight, like, I'm so stressed out that, like, I constantly feel like I'm gonna shit my pants. And so, like, yeah, it's just like the day of flying is never good for me because I won't drink anything. I will not take a sip of water. I will not eat a single freaking crumb because I'm so scared and like I'm so stressed about flying that I think I'm going to like either throw it up or shit my pants. Yeah. So I was already scared, stressed about the entire day because like my flight's so late, so I haven't consumed water or food or anything. So like I'm ill. Okay, I'm ill and I'm trying to make this fly, girl. I'm also about to get my period tomorrow. Yeah, of course. It's either gonna come today or he'll all hit. That was not there. That was not there 3 days ago. Yeah, so anyways, I make my flight. Long story short, guys, I make it. I don't know how. Like, I literally get through security, check my bags with 2 minutes to spare. Like, they're about to board this flight as I'm running over there. Made it. Don't know how. Got here. Have to have a plane at LAX, except for, babe, we do not fly into LAX. If you fly into LAX, I'm convinced that you hate yourself. Oh, I stopped. Finally! Finally! Yes! Yes! Do you hear it? Because it stopped. Once upon a time ago, I would always fly into LAX because you think LA, you think California, you're gonna fly into LAX. Where the fuck else are the airports, right? So every single time that I used to fly from probably the span of like 2016 to like 2020 maybe, or 2019, no, maybe 2019, I don't know. A couple years I was flying into LAX. Every single time I would fly into LAX, guess what? For some reason, since everybody and their motherfucking mother is trying to call an Uber, there was no Ubers for me. And so I would sit on the curb in the hot, in the 100 degree weather. It wasn't 100 degrees, it was like 80, but it felt a lot, okay? And then I would wait for an entire Uber to pick me up. And then guess what? The kicker of it all, the Uber was $120. Do you know how much food I could buy? I could do an entire gardening haul with that. Like, you know, like, girl, like what? I found out that there's something called Burbank Airport. It is slightly more expensive. It depends because low-key sometimes like when I look like it is the same as LAX, but sometimes it's like $50 or $100. I'll pay it because it's smaller and the Ubers like that, like so freaking quick. And guess what? For some reason, every single time I fly from Burbank to wherever I need to go, the Uber's like $50 or less than $40. LAX is $120. Yeah, so I flew into Burbank and it was great. Fast forward to yesterday, you guys. Yesterday. I just wanna like literally strangle. I wanna strangle the life out of somebody. I do, okay. I'm really not trying to be a violent person. Okay, now we're moving on to the face. I'm gonna put the lashes on as the very, very last step because I can't even bug with them right now. Bobbi Brown, Vitamin Enriched. Let's pray that the base, everybody. Dear base gods, please make me beautiful and gorgeous. I already want to have a mental breakdown, so please make me look beautiful and gorgeous. Thank you. Okay. Guys, I literally love this. Like, look at how much. It's so good. You guys, if you guys have never gotten it, it's actually worth the money, okay? Like, I spent my own money on that, so, like, if I spent my own hard-working money on that, girl, you should too. It's actually amazing. So, we're gonna prime my face real quick with this. So, yesterday I wake up and like we wake up like honestly kind of like early, like 8 o'clock or something like that. So I'm already thinking, oh great, we woke up at 8 o'clock, girls. Like we're gonna be up all night. I'm scared, you know, because I'm kind of like an in bed. I mean, like sometimes I'll stay up late and all that stuff, but I'm usually like an in bed by like 9-10 p.m. girly, like full skincare routine with my dog. I have a freaking eye base. Like, bye. We're literally gonna put it on. This is like so bouge. An eye primer for under the eyes, babe. This is bougie. Okay, so we wake up yesterday and we're both like, I'm like, I wish I let my little sister like cut my hair before I came here. Like, I feel like it's just like dry on the ends and like, I just want a little trim. I want a fresh trim, you know, a fresh trim. So we both decided that we're going to get haircuts, which, okay, guys, I have an emotional attachment to my hair. I just do, okay? I have an emotional attachment to my hair. I like long hair and I don't like short hair. I don't. It's just not what I think looks good on me personally. So I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go in there and I'm going to get a trim. So Google hair place behind around us, and there was some kind of like hair salon. It was called like Gloria's Hair Salon, or I don't freaking know. It was called something like that, and it was some kind of like hair salon, and the reviews were amazing. And so we were like, yeah, we're gonna go here. Like, girls go here, guys go here. Like, this is just all around a good place, has really, really good reviews, and it was like really, really close to like where we were. So we're like, yeah, let's do it. So we call them and we're like, can we get an appointment? And we're like, yeah. They're like, coming right now. We coming right now. So I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm white as hell. Yeah, I'm white as hell. And a majority of the people, like, I'm white as hell, but my best friend is Mexican and she knows how to speak Spanish, thank God. So, you know, like, it's never really like an issue for me. Well, we go and get our haircut, and I guess the lady that I got she speaks English. She does speak a little bit of English, but she doesn't like fully. And she told me that, and I was like, that's totally fine. Like, I don't care, you know? So she's like, what do you want? And I kind of like, I explained it to her, and she seems like fully, like she understands, because like she knows enough where like she can understand, right? And I'm like, okay, like I show her how much, like I just want to, guys, my hair used to be to like right here. I'm talking like my butt crack is right here. And it would like go in my butt crack, okay? Like it literally would like go in my butt crack. Like that's how long my freaking hair was. And like, I was like, I like my long hair. Like I have an attachment to my hair. Like you guys know that, blah, 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 blah. So I tell her, I was like, I don't want too much off. I was like, I want the deadness off. But like if it's too dead, don't cut it off. Don't cut it all off, okay? Don't do me like that. So she's like, okay, okay, okay. And I show her how much I tell her, like literally I want this much off. Like literally just take this much off. And then I decide that I want some little like pieces of bangs, because like my little like side pieces of bangs were literally like grown all the way out because I hadn't like got them done in like, you know, forever. So I'm like, this is going good. She starts cutting like my bangs and all that stuff. And low key, I'm not even kidding, I was a little scared because she starts like razor blading it. And like, I now found out that that's like how you're supposed to like do like these little like side bang pieces and all that stuff. I was scared though, cause I was like, she's pulling out the razor blade. I'm just like, every single time I go get like a haircut or something like that, terrified, like genuinely, like deathly terrified, because 9 times out of 10, well, those are the same girls that I just saw, her pretty dress, is she doing laps around the apartment? I don't know. Basically 9 times out of 10, they cut my hair too short, and then I go home and have a mental breakdown, period. Period. Well, she does my bangs, and I'm like, oh my god, this is doing so good. So like, I'm sitting here like in my head like, oh, like how much am I gonna tip her? I think I'm gonna tip her more just because I have a lot of hair, like, you know, she's doing like a lot, she's putting like these oils and these leave-ins, and so like I'm borderline, I borderline tip her 50%. I'm not even shit. Like when I told her how much I wanted to tip, I tipped her like $30, okay? I tipped her $30 and the haircut was $50, okay? That's over 50%, is it not? I don't know like my percentages, but like, yeah. I was like, cause I have a lot of hair, like this girl, like, you know, like, and so I see it and everything looks totally fine except for the fact that I was like, low key, fuck, she cut it too short, like fuck. You know, like she cut so much off. You guys, I think she literally cut like 12 inches off. I'm not even fucking like, and I was like, okay, like whatever, like, you know, I needed it. But here's the thing, my hair was wet. So you know how like when your hair's wet, you know how like when your hair is wet and it's longer. So like, I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. Like, you know, like it's still like, you know, like she cut some off, but like, it's not that bad. Babe, I pay her all that stuff. We go home and my hair air dries. It was so short. I'm not even fucking with you guys when I say my hair is here now. My hair went from here I wish I was lying. Not even the kicker of it all, okay? That's not even the kicker. Sorry guys, that's not even the kicker of it all. You guys want to know the kicker? You guys want to know the real freaking, the real kicker? The real kicker is that she didn't cut it even. And I wish I was lying. I literally wish I was lying. I was sitting there and like obviously I'm not home like with my family. And so I told them that I got a haircut and they're like, oh, I want to see it. So like I sent a video or whatever. And like how we took the video was a little crooked. So I was like, I tell them in the video, I was like, sorry, the video is crooked. Like my hair's not crooked. Then I'm like, I start to look at my hair and I'm like, why do I feel like one side is longer than the other? Like, why do I feel like one side is low key longer than the other? And then I start like matching them together and I'm like, holy motherfucking shit. This fucking bitch. This side was this much longer than this side. So like, it looks like this. I'm not even like, I straightened it. I'm not even exaggerating. I straightened it. And after I straightened, like this is after we've already cut in so much off. Okay, me and Bianca tried to fix it, cut so much off, and then I straightened it, and there was still so much of a difference. You guys, I was gonna go back and get it fixed today, but I literally don't have freaking time, and so we're gonna try and, like, fix it a little bit. I just can't even honestly believe that happened to me. I can't even believe that I just, like, I think the kicker of it all is just that I really wanted to be nice, and I was like, I have a lot of hair, and I think she, like, did good. Like, she seems like she did good. Like, she did all these things. I tipped her a lot, like, you know, and then it just, she didn't do right. She didn't do right. I'm physically unwell. All day yesterday I was fixated on my hair, and if you're a girl with like long hair, then like I think you get it, you know, like you get it. You're like probably in the comments like, oh Maddie, I'm so sorry. Yeah, you get it. I guess the good thing is that my hair does grow out fast, but honest to God, I think it's gonna take a little bit long. Thank God I just went to Hawaii and I did my little like long Hawaii vacation. Yeah, thank God I did that. But I really, really wanna go back and I'm like, I don't want short hair. I think I'm gonna go back at like the end of the year again or whatever. But yeah, you guys, the hair, she doesn't hair anymore. And all I kept thinking to myself is like, so like once upon a time ago, like when I didn't have like extremely long hair, like I had long hair, but I didn't have like extremely long hair, I would wear hair extensions. And so like in the beginning of like my black hair, I had like hair extensions and I still have them like to this day. Like I would only ever wear them like every now and then. And so I was literally like saying yesterday, I was like, I'm gonna have to start wearing my hair extensions just so I have long hair. Guys, you guys are gonna see it and you guys are gonna be like, Maddie, you're so freaking dramatic. And you guys are gonna see that it. it's really not that ugly. And like, it actually is, it's not cute. The front pieces are cute. Like that's the thing, like the little bang and like the front pieces she did so good on, but the rest of it, I'm kind of just like, ew-y. I just don't like, I don't like short hair on me. I think it's the fact that I have a fat face. So like when it's short, I just feel like it makes me look like short and stubby. But like if I have long hair, then it kind of like elongates my face and doesn't make me look like as fat faced. We're gonna like Dyson her out. And because like yesterday she was like air dried, so like I just felt like it didn't look the style. Like now my hair's kind of like dampish wet. So we're gonna like Dyson her out and like hopefully she makes me beautiful and gorgeous. And I like her, but like, there's just been a lot of changes happening to me recently that was just a little too much, you know. The Made by Mitchell liquid blush in Sweet Cheeks, you guys. It's like this really, really hot pink, like beautiful, gorgeous, like pink blush. I cannot get over it. I keep only grabbing for her. Ugh. Look at how like just pretty this pink is. Ugh, she is just stunning and gives a nice little blush. And last night, basically we got invited to this little like, it was some kind of like event. Like it was like a Galore magazine type event slash Bad Girl Club. Okay guys, I've been obsessed with Bad Girls Club. Guys, the lighting just totally dimmed. I'm sorry. What the heck just happened? Where'd she go? The lighting. Going in and out, I'm sorry, whatever, okay. I'm sorry. Okay, so whatever. It was like, I've been obsessed with Bad Girls Club recently. If you guys did not know that, it's been like my favorite show. Like I'm addicted. It's like my guilty pleasure, like late at night, like sit in bed with like my skincare, do a little dab, and I watch my Bad Girls Club. Like that is like my night routine. It is like actually the most greatest thing ever. We're gonna go with Chloe Mercier today. Bad Girls was hosting this event or whatever, or like this thing. And so I was like, wait, I love her. Natalie Nunn was hosting the event, which I feel like people either love or hate her. But honestly, people like hate on her a lot and they're like, oh, she's ugly, blah, blah, blah. No, she actually was like really beautiful and gorgeous in person. I'll probably post the video that like I saw of her. She didn't come to like later on in the event. The event was only like 3 hours and like we didn't show up until 9. And so I think like she showed up around like 10. Like that's like my plan tonight. Like we're gonna come home like later tonight and it's gonna be like 1 o'clock in the morning or like 12, and we're gonna watch Bad Girls Club. A really, really great, amazing time. Eat some Taco Bell and then watch Bad Girls Club. Yeah, so we went to that. It was actually like really fun. And I got to see one of my friends that I haven't seen literally in like years. Like I think since 2017 was like the last time that I got to see him. And so it was like actually funny because he like swiped up to my story or like sent me like one of my stories and he's like, oh my God, I love this bag or whatever. It was like my Facetune sponsored post or whatever, which guys, I got a sponsored post with Facetune, like what? Anyways, yeah. But he like sent it to me or whatever. And he's like, oh my God, I love this bag, blah, 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 like miss you. And I was like, bitch, shut the fuck up, I'm going to LA. I was like, bitch, shut the fuck up. Like, I'm literally like coming tonight. Like literally replied instantly. He replied instantly. And yeah, so we got to see him cause he went to the event. He's like, come to this event with me, please. Like, I want to go, but I don't want to go alone, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yeah, babe, like, let's go, right? Original plan was like, we were just going to go to this event and then me and Bianca were going to come home. We were going to wake up early because like I said, we were supposed to go to the beach today and have breakfast on the beach and all this stuff. Yeah, babe, we didn't get home till 3 a.m. Okay, so yeah. And so then me and Bianca have this mutual friend, Alexis, and she's like, hey, I just woke up. You guys want to go out? Yeah, babe, let's go out. What the fuck? I get ready for no reason. I'm just kidding. But yeah, so she's like, okay, I'm getting ready right now. Like, come to my house and then blah, blah, blah. So we basically go to her house. She's like getting ready or whatever, which she's a trooper. She literally did a wine tasting all day long. Got turned the fuck up, took a nap and was like, round 2, girls. And then she fully got up and went to church today and like went somewhere else and like, yeah, so like she's a trooper, okay? So basically, we went to her house or whatever and we decided to go to Delilah last night, which if you didn't know what Delilah is, I always wanted to go, like I've never been. Apparently they have like, a lot of people go there like during the day for like food and stuff like that, but like at night it turns into like a nightclub or whatever. And so we go there because she had like a friend there that was there for like a birthday party or something like that. And so we decided to go there. So we go there and if you guys didn't know, it's like a club where like you can't really like take photos or like pictures or like do like really anything on your phone because a lot of celebrities, like that's like the club that apparently Drake goes to all the time. Like that's like the only club that he goes to. And so a lot of celebrities, like high profile people will go there, all that stuff. So we get there and we go to the table and our table's like all the way like in the back. And I just want to preface, I'm not a tequila drinker. I'm a vodka girly, okay? I'm a vodka or a Bacardi type of girly. I'm not a tequila. I don't know how you people do it. I really don't. So this fucking table obviously only has tequila. And I'm like, I honestly don't even care because babe, I have my wax pen, okay? Like I'm good, right? Like if you guys didn't know this, like I don't really drink that much. I do and I don't. Like I do it for like special occasions, but it's not like all the time. Like if I find a drink that's really, really good, that's why like honestly I want to come out with like an alcohol that like does not taste like alcohol, because I feel like every alcohol tastes like alcohol. I don't freaking know. Anyways. So this guy, I guess, is like on one or something like that. Like it's like three dudes and like a bunch of girls. And it's like, it's his table and then like his best friend's table who's like a girl or something like that. And I don't know, he starts fucking tweaking out. He has this fucking bottle and he's like wanting like everyone to like take shots from this bottle or something. And I'm like, first of all, no. Second of all, there was probably backwash floaties floating around in that. Like you want, what? Like, I get it, like, you know, but, like, that's not, you know, I'm sorry, you're really asking the wrong fucking person, okay, like, you're asking the wrong person, because all of the girls were, like, what the fuck, bitch, like, no, like, give me a fucking cup, what the fuck, and so this motherfucker starts going on one, he starts tweaking, and he's, like, why are you guys here, then, if you don't even want to drink this, why are you guys here if you guys don't want to drink this bottle out of the bottle with me? And even like his like girlfriend / friend, or I don't know, she looked at him and she's like, what the fuck, like leave them the fuck alone, like these are my friends, like you're fucking weird, you know? And so he was on one and he's like, I want them out of this table. Okay, so it's just gonna be you at the table alone, because like she's gonna leave and she's gonna come with us, so you're just gonna sit at the table alone. And so he's like, I want them gone. And she's like, no, this is my table. Like, yeah, this is your table, but this is my table and they're my friends and blah, blah, blah. So the guy was fucking weird. And basically I was just like, ew, like he's a fucking weirdo. Like, bitch, go get a vodka then. If you want somebody to fucking drink, go get a vodka, you dumb fucking whore. Thank you. Anyways. And so I was kind of like, okay, that's fucking weird. So basically these other two girls that like we were with, so like my friend Alexis, like her friends, she was like, one of her friends was like, oh my god, my friend's coming here. Like, I just want to say, preface, it was 1 o'clock in the morning when her friend showed up. The club closes at 2. This man came in, bought a table at 1 o'clock in the morning when we can only have the table for an hour. So we move over to this table with him and he was so sweet, so nice. Like, I guess like it was like a family, like one of their family friends or something like that. He gets a table, all this stuff. He's like, he gets his tequila because he likes the tequila of the 1942. But he's like, if you guys want anything, like, oh, get it. Like, amazing. So basically the vibe was really, really nice. I had like, honestly, like once we switched that table, it was so fun. It was so nice. You know, like we were having a good time. Except for, babe, I was getting an ocular migraine and it was actually scary. I'm like full blown, like in the club, like trying to like text people because they're texting me, right? And I can't see. My eyes are like blurring together, like going like different directions. Like my eyes, it's like, it's as if I like took like 30 drinks and I'm like blacked out, but I did not, you know, like I'm sipping on a vodka cranberry. And so like my eyes were blurring together, whatever. It was really fun. And then I met these two girls that were like my friend Alexis's friends, and I literally love them, literally love both of them. And they're so funny. I'm like, we like post the video or whatever. We were trying to like, we were sitting by like this fire and it was like, dude, there's like a hair or something and it's bugging me. We were sitting by this fire and it was like melting us. And so we were like trying to like turn it off, but like we couldn't get it off. So there's this video of one of the girls, her name's Roma. She's literally so amazing. I love her. And she like kept trying to like pour water on it or like pour our drinks on it to like turn the fire off. Cause like I was melting, like full blown, like melting, like stuff is like coming down my face for an hour. And this table we were at for like an hour or whatever. So it's time to leave. And the club was really nice. I did like it. It was a cute vibe. And then we go outside and then the person that literally bought the table or whatever bought me flowers. Like, you know, like how like some people like stand outside and like those huge bouquet of flowers, like trying to like sell them like after a club, you know? It's amazing. And then we literally got home at like 2 o'clock in the morning. And guys, I felt so ill because yesterday I didn't eat or drink like any water. Yesterday, all I ate was Taco Bell. And the day before, guys, you guys know, I was on a flight. And so because I was on flight, I didn't eat anything and I didn't drink anything. So for 2 days, I low-key didn't eat or drink anything. I was like physically so freaking ill last night, guys. I was actually like scared. And so that's why today, our whole plan was to get up at like 7 o'clock in the morning, get ready and go to the beach and eat breakfast on the beach. No, babe, no. The way that I felt last night, I was like convincing myself like not to throw up because I wasn't like a drunk or like hungover like throw up. It was like, I'm so freaking tired and I'm so like overly like hungry type thing. And like whenever I'm like hungry or if I like stay up for too long or whatever, I get sick, like physically like nauseous, like ill. And like, guys, it's just really, really not good at all. Like it happens all the freaking time. It's really sad. We're switching our plans and we're actually gonna go to like this Mexican restaurant. I think like on the beach, like Santa Monica Pier. But we think it's gonna be really, really busy. So we're maybe thinking like we're gonna do to go and then like go sit on the beach and like eat like on the beach. Like the restaurant's on the beach, but like we can either like sit in the restaurant, but like if it's, they take no reservations, you guys. I'm with this Allure Mercier bronzer. You guys know that I love this bronzer. This is number 2, but I also have number 3. So because I'm like a little tan right now, I'm like, do I do number 3? I think I'm gonna go with the lighter one. Or maybe the darker one. I don't know.
Now wait, which shoulder is on? Oh, it's not even in the way.
Oh, I'm gonna kill myself because like I should have like took that off the entire time. Like, why do I now look good? Like, there is no freaking way.
Well, she's gonna stay there.
Okay. Guys, like this entire time we could have looked like this. Guys, I had to bring my Rare Beauty because I broke her. She fell on the ground and then she fell on the ground again. So just fair warning, if you have the Rare Beauty highlighter, yeah, you actually have a lot more than like I did though. Like when I saw yours last night, I was like, oh, okay, wow. But yeah, mine's like, yeah. So I brought this one because we were not gonna risk. You guys know I love my Kylie one. The Kylie X Stoss one is literally so freaking amazing. And so I was not gonna risk that one getting broken because for some reason the highlighter is like, the glue is coming like off the highlighter, so it's kind of like popping out. And so I was like, no, we can't even risk her. So we brought the broken one forever. She's going to be my travel one because if it breaks again, I really don't care. She broke first. I was flabbergasted. Okay, I was shocked. Mainly because this specific highlighter, like in this shade, was always sold out. And every single time that I wanted to buy it, it was like sold out, sold out, sold out. So then when it finally came in stock and I got the notification, duh, I bought it immediately. And then she cracks. Like, are you kidding me? But it's fine. It's okay. Because there's actually like still some, like as you can see, like I'm still like able to use it. But I do gotta say, like that was really triggersome. Okay. I got our little inner corner highlight. Okay. Now, like, am I the same shade everywhere? I look like I'm the same shade, right? The lashes that I usually like, I cannot find. I like freaking lost them. They're somewhere like in my room. So I had to do lashes that I don't usually use. Guys, I hated them. I had to glue this one on. I'm very particular about my lashes. And I always say this. There's only like about like 2 to 3 styles that I'll actually like wear. And I'm really specific with how the band feels. I'm really specific. Like I will not just wear any type of lash. In the end, I did look kind of ish cute last night. But then my romper, I was wearing like this really cute, like little off the shoulder romper that I got from Fashion Nova or whatever. And like, it's supposed to like lay like, but it just kept like riding up. So it was kind of annoying me. Also, you guys, this YSL mascara is so freaking good. Like, look at this wand. I'm actually obsessed with it. It's literally so good. You're lying. She be making me look like I have lashes, guys. It's actually really good. I want to try the brown version of this. I got the brown version, but then I ended up like giving the brown version to my little sister because she likes brown mascara. And so I really want to try it though. I really, really like this one. I need to stop doing this because I'm giving myself a forehead wrinkle. Also, guys, I'm literally so dehydrated that I have a dehydration line on my forehead. You guys don't know this, I don't get Botox or anything, and I'm a very expressive person, and I should, but I'm terrified of needles. Actually, deathly scared. Like, if you come with me by a needle, I'm gonna start like hyperventilating and like have a panic attack on the floor. I wish I was exaggerating. Like, I wish I was exaggerating. Like, it's really that embarrassing. I just accidentally like take off the front of my eyebrow when doing my makeup. Definitely distant cousins. I don't like how thick that one is. But we already set the face. We already set the face, so there's really nothing I can do. No. Okay. Cute. We need to do the lip combo. I need to go grab my bag real quick. BRB. Everyone and their mother talks about this Wherever Walnut Lip Liner from Makeup Forever, so I wanted to be like a girly. But I think I love this. Also, oh my god, you guys, I got this new Lawless lip gloss in the shade Velvet. She's so freaking pretty, and like, look at the wand, you guys. She like forms to your lip, like perfectly, like, and it's supposed to be like a line smoother, so like it fills in the lines, because like I don't have any lip filler, so like I have like little like lines on my lips. This MAC lipstick, I think that's what the lip combo is gonna be, but I need to go find my lip balm. BRB again. Okay guys, we got the lip balm, but I have to like, there's low-key like foundation. Friday's vanilla lip balm. I don't care what anyone says, this is the best one. This is the best one out of all of the scents. People and the girlies gonna be like, no, pink sugar is, no, it's not, okay? The vanilla one is the best one. Coming from the girl that has had every single one, I've had every single one, and I literally had to like return the other ones because I liked this one so much that I just didn't like the other ones. Like, I used the other ones and I was like, oh. Except for one of them, I missed the return window. So like, I got the pink sugar one, then I got the red one, and then I returned both of those because I was like, no, the pink sugar one made me nauseous. The smell was like actually horrendous. I liked the color on my lips, but like the smell was too sweet that like, I was like, I'm actually gonna throw up on the ground. Then I got the red one and I was like, oh, this is just like not my vibe. So the vanilla, yeah. I've gone through like two of these tubes. I actually have like a brand new one that I just got. I should have brought it, but. So we've gone through like three. No, we've gone through two and we're on our third one. It's actually that amazing, so. I also usually use a Q-tip, but I don't know why Q-tip is. I think we're gonna mix these two lip liners today. I think it's a little bit more natural. Should I do some or should I do this one? I mean, I'm gonna show you guys to open always letting go of my arms. Let's do a beautiful favorite this one, and you are not it. This one's not it. Okay. This is Wherever Walnut. Yesterday I mixed actually both of these together. Like, I lined my lips with the brown one and then like I like filled in with this one. But this is Wherever Walnut by Makeup Forever. All of the girlies say that they freaking love it. And like, I love her, but I'm also not like 100% like sold on her, if that makes sense at all. Like, I do enjoy her, but I'm also like, I think the problem is that I'm just so used to like brown lip liners that like seeing myself with like a pink or like a nude is just like, huh? I go in with, where is it? But I just had it. Okay, this is MAC lipstick and cream cup. I really wanted to bring Blankety. I guess they're really, really similar. My Blankety one is low-key broken. And do I want to add this gloss? Frick, but then I feel like I need like the dark lip liner to contrast it. Okay, this is the Lawless gloss in Velvet, which is like really pretty. Cute. It like really matches like the lip combo. Like, this whole like lip combo is just like a really nice like nudie pink. We're gonna double spray it. So I have my Urban Decay All Nighter, and then I also have my One Size. So I'm gonna go in with the Urban Decay All Nighter first, and you guys, look, it's like so cute, like travel. I actually like ran out of this, so I had to pour some of like my big bottle like into this because I was running out of it. Gotta make sure that we're all nighted, girl. We gotta make sure that we're all nighted. Okay, this is the One Size waterproof one. I really like this one, but you, not even kidding you, you like literally have to like hold your breath, because I one time did not hold my breath and like it shot up my nose, and that was really scary, honestly. Like, it burned so bad. Okay. Don't breathe, just don't breathe for a little bit. Okay. Okay, guys, so the lashes are on. Now we're going to go to the bathroom to do my hair. This is what the makeup looks like right now. This lash is giving me so much problems, and I low-key accidentally got glue all over the lash, like literally all up here. So pray for me. These are the lashes and I literally hate them, but it's fine. First step, ibuprofen, guys, because I genuinely, my head hurts so bad that it's making me go. That is causing wrinkles, okay? To not cause the wrinkles, we need to take some ibuprofen. Because like I said, I'm about to get my period, guys. I'm also like really tired. Sorry, like, sorry for sort of like, it's the messy background. It's in like the process, like, this apartment just got moved into a week ago, so. What the fuck? What the hell is that light to? There's a light switch on the ceiling. You guys are really mad at me. You're literally so dramatic, but like, I'm really not that dramatic. You guys can already see. Here, and see if we can do something to her. First step. You guys, this smells so good, and I love it. Honestly, that is like a sprayish. Brush out my short freaking hair that this lady botched. Okay, you guys, we are done getting ready. I put on this dress. This is for New Year's, like a couple years ago, and then I never used it. It's not on, but I'm gonna do like a little thumbnail back. Okay, you guys, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I'll try and vlog some. I wish I could vlog last night, but literally where I was, you could not take photos and videos. I took like one little picture, but I could have gotten kicked out, okay? So yeah, this is the look, you guys. Like, she cut my hair so short, so please appreciate how long and luscious my Hawaii hair is. I love you.